I'd like to bring you some good news from West Bengal, substantiated by hard data, agreed upon by the government of India's CSO, Central Statistical Organization. For the last 2 years, our econometricians and officers of the state have been debating with CSO on what is the GDP of the state of West Bengal. Today, I am delighted to tell you that 3 days ago, the Central Statistical Organization of the Government of India has arrived with us at a consensus on what is the rate of growth of GDP of the state, what is the size of the GDP of the state, and of course, what has been the industrial performance of the state, among others. I am delighted to tell you that in the year 2017-18, using a 2011-12 base used by all states now, in the year 2017-18, India grew by 6.70% GDP, which you may know, but the Central Statistical Organization of Government of India agrees that West Bengal grew by 9.15%, all measured in constant prices. So 6.7% India, West Bengal 9.15%. Phenomenal growth indeed. And you'll be happy to know that the central government, Government of India, has uplinked this data for everyone to see. So please check the website and you'll be happy to see the dynamic performance of West Bengal under the leadership of Mamata Banerjee, the Chief Minister. Let me ask you, you're curious to know what has been the industrial growth of West Bengal. Times that people have said all kinds of things. You'll be happy to know that Government of India, Central Statistical Organization has agreed, while India grew in the industrial sector in constant prices, India grew by 5.4% vis-a-vis its industrial sector. West Bengal grew by 16.29%. I repeat, India grew by 5.54% in the industrial sector in 17-18. West Bengal grew by 16.29%. Phenomenal growth indeed. Let me turn now to the question of manufacturing growth within the category of industry. There have been a lot of talk of investments into West Bengal, controversies raised. Here is the hard data. The Government of India has agreed with this data. While Indian manufacturing in 2017-18 grew by 5.74% India, West Bengal grew by 10.20% in manufacturing. So you've already heard the industry data as a whole. Now I break it down to manufacturing in particular. You'd be happy to know India grew by 5.74%. West Bengal grew by 10.20%. Brilliant. Now you can ask, what has been, which sector within industry has positioned itself as a very high growth rate? Well, come to construction. You'll be interested to know India grew by the same 5.74% in construction. West Bengal grew by 27.63%. If you take any aspect, whether it's electricity, India grew by 7.17%. West Bengal grew by 18.27%. So wherever you look, it's mining. India grew by 2.94%, West Bengal grew by 4.44%. So within the category of industry, among these four elements, manufacturing skipping forward, way ahead of India. Construction absolutely rising dramatically, way above India. Same is the case for electricity, mining. So what is the conclusion we can arrive at? And check it out on the website of Central Statistical Organization, the data I am giving you. We started with GDP growth, phenomenal growth of West Bengal, 6.7 India, 9.15 West Bengal. Then we went to industrial growth of India, again phenomenal growth, 5.54% India, 16.29% West Bengal. Can you beat that? Now we break down industry into four categories. The one that you're interested in, manufacturing. Phenomenal growth relative to India. India grows by 5.74%, West Bengal goes by 10.20%. So what we can submit today is that West Bengal is way ahead of India as accepted by the government of India, none other than the Central Statistical Organization. May I also add, what has happened to GDP in absolute numbers, you may want to know. Well, 10 lakh crores was our target, which people scoffed at. West Bengal GDP in 2017-18, 10 lakh crores. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you'd be happy to know that as accepted by Government of India, West Bengal in 17-18, the GDP it posted is 10,21,000 crores. We have crossed that bar of 10 lakh crores GDP as accepted by the Central Statistical Organization. So I'm delighted to say that now that Government of India, after 2 years of debate, has arrived at a consensus with West Bengal, now we will redo the statistic for the 15th Finance Commission as per the Government of India's agreement and submit it to them, and they would be delighted. We had made this commitment, we'll do this in August and we'll go ahead. Now let me come back for a moment. What made this happen? Well, first of all, what made such a phenomenal GDP growth happen is capital expenditure in the state of West Bengal, which means asset creating expenditure, roads, schools, colleges, water systems, whatever creates permanent assets. They have the highest Keynesian multiplier effect, as economists would say. So if you spend 100 rupees on asset creating expenditure, your GDP ultimately can go up by as much as four times. So the Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee concentrated on capital expenditure. Let me give you the figure. In 2010-11, capital expenditure in West Bengal was only 2,225 crores. What happens in 2017-18? 2,225 crores jumps to 21,561 crores. 21,561 crores. This will give a naturally a kick to the growth of GDP, which today Government of India has accepted. Same is the case for plan expenditure. Again, a multiplier effect comes from plan expenditure. In 2010-11, it was 14,615 crores. What is it today? In 17-18, from 14,000 plus, it has jumped to 60,000 crores. Again, a big kick to the growth of GDP. And the last point I'll make is, none of them would have been possible by me as finance minister allocating resources. It had to be implemented on the ground. So Mamata Banerjee, the Honorable Chief Minister, held over 400 district level meetings, project by project of asset creating expenditure, whether it's roads, whether it's irrigation, you name it. Because of the 400 plus meetings in the districts of West Bengal on implementation, the Chief Minister made sure that the multiplier effect that we are talking about, the Keynesian multiplier, in fact is released. Therefore, on one hand, growth in capital expenditure, on the other hand, the growth in plan expenditure, and in the third hand, implementation at the grassroots level by Chief Ministers over 400 meetings. The three put together creates the chemistry and the physics of how the GDP growth has happened in West Bengal, now agreed to by the government of India. Please tell other people when you hear this, of this phenomenal achievement, aside of course from the fact that United Nations gave the highest award to West Bengal, where Mamata Banerjee received this award in The Hague in Netherlands for Kanyashri. And by the way, in 11 areas, West Bengal is number one in India today. Most of these awards given by Government of India. Another day and another time, I would like to dwell on what has been the number one position of West Bengal in a number of areas. Thank you.